If you'd like to watch more of 7:30's stories, they are on the left of your screen.
For another weekend, thousands of protesters converged on Australia's major cities, Melbourne again the epicentre.
While more than 90% of Victorians have returned to normal life, thousands of protesters marched to the beat of their own drum.
Authorities were forced to close Spring Street to allow for the mass gathering at the steps of Parliament House. This latest protest comes just over a week after Melbourne reopened to vaccinated residents.
Thousands of protesters have marched through Sydney rallying against COVID vaccine mandates. It was one of several demonstrations across the country.
As thousands again marched through the streets of Sydney CBD. While in Melbourne, protesters directed their anger at Premier Daniel Andrews.
Well, Melbourne's protest movement refuses to slow down. City streets have been swarmed as tens of thousands rallied against the state government's proposed pandemic bill.
A sea of protesters riding their wave of discontent. From the air, an extraordinary mass of Victorians.
For those here, it's about strength in numbers and they want people to know us. So whether it's thousands or tens of thousands or more, one thing's...
With no way to count, it's the pictures that will tell that story, though it wasn't quite poetry.
And live now to Adam Hegarty. Adam, police are looking for several people after previous protests.
Indeed there are, Alicia. We'll bring images of those people straight up on the screen for you now. It's to do with protests back in September.
Large crowds gathered at Sydney's Hyde Park to take part in the anti-vax march. While in Adelaide, hundreds took to the streets of Hindmarsh, forcing one media organisation into lockdown.
Thousands of protesters rallied outside Channel 7 Adelaide's Hindmarsh headquarters today, bringing traffic to a standstill.
The mainstream media is lying to the people of Australia.
A Saturday ritual. Protesters clogging Melbourne's streets, hitting out at vaccine mandates and the pandemic bill. The controversial legislation is set to be debated this week.
For the fifth Saturday in a row, our city streets swamped.
It's just disgusting. I can't believe I haven't got a choice here.
At times, a party atmosphere with drums and DJs. Today, and they say there were around 20,000 protesters. Some of those there that I spoke with today, the protesters, said that was well into the hundreds of thousands. But one number they can all agree on, Mike.
Victorians against mandatory coronavirus vaccinations have marched through the city as part of the nationwide protest.
Protest here, which is part of the nationwide Millions March protest. We believe there are about hundreds of thousands of people in attendance.
Premier, thanks so much for speaking with us. Why do you deserve another term as Premier?
I had a terrible injury earlier in the year and I've had more than a few people say to me, well, why'd you come back? I came back because I'm absolutely committed to finishing this job, to getting the job done, and there's so much more to do.
Bill, currently before the Upper House, is proving controversial. There's a lot of people that have an issue with it for one reason or another. To the protesters, why don't you stand on the steps of Parliament and address their concerns?
Protest is very important. Protest is perfectly legit, but if it's not peaceful, it's not protest. It's something very, very different. It's the safety of every single Victorian family.
Before the...
So, what should the media have done? Put simply, be more careful and less credulous, and don't convict anyone until the evidence is in. That is good advice, even if it is too late for the media in this case. Could happen to anyone. So, trust no one and check.